All right, chat. Since, like, I always have people coming in here in chat being like, hey, favorite boss? Why wouldn't we do this? It's like free real estate, dude. Isn't this like a 10-head idea? We can start with... Do you want to start with shit tier? We can start there. Shit tier boss. Where are they? I fucking hate this boss. With all of my being. Fuck this boss. I get pissed off every time I enter this boss fight. Doesn't matter. What happens? I leave angry. Shit tier boss. Do I have another shit tier boss? What other boss do I leave angry? I don't think there's any other boss that I, like, leave as angry as I leave the Deacons of the Deep. Okay, so next we can go D tier. This one's easy to fill up. We can go with, I think Curse Rod and Great Wood's kind of lame. I think Ancient Wyvern's kind of a gimmick fight, so very lame. Half-Light, D tier. Crystal Sage, very forgettable. You think Wolnir's D tier? I actually think Wolnir, just like presentation-wise, I think Wolnir is like a C tier boss. Other C tier boss, probably Gravetender. Yep. I'm gonna put Old Demon King in C tier because Old Demon King, for like how lame and out of the way it is, like the arena itself tells a really good story, and I just feel bad for beating the old man into oblivion. So we're gonna put Old Demon King in C tier. The reason I didn't put Half-Light in shit is because I actually don't leave Half-Light pissed off. Like, the only boss in this game that pisses me off is fucking Deacons. Every time I go into Deacons, like, I leave angry, okay? Doesn't matter. Eudex Gundyr, tutorial boss, very average. Very average. I don't really have much of an opinion besides that. I think I'll put Osiris in B tier. He pisses me off, but, like, I feel like the only reason I get pissed off is from my own shortcomings fighting him. Like, overall, he's kind of a fun boss. His lore is pretty cool. He's like a big scaly. Like, he read enough Seath fanfiction that he turned into a dragon. Yorm the Giant, B tier. It's kind of a gimmick fight, but I think the gimmick's pretty cool. And you're not forced to use the gimmick, so that kind of brings some creativity to the fight. Like, they offer you a gimmick in this fight, but you can still fight him without the gimmick, which is cool. I think Demon Prince is in C tier, by the way. I think it's okay fight. It's like a gank fight, which automatically makes it semi-annoying. But it's like very average to me. Pontiff, I'll put in B tier. Yeah, I like beating the shit out of this boss. It feels good when you beat the shit out of this boss. And he's actually difficult when you do no parry stuff. And it's really impressive when people do no roll stuff. So I'll put Pontiff B tier. Plus he has nice feet, I guess. Dark Eater Madeir. Big thick dragon. I'll put Vort in B tier for being big booty as well. Cool soundtrack. Really good first boss. I think Champion Gundyr is B tier. Mostly because it's like upgraded tutorial Gundyr. So I guess like why wouldn't you put it like one tier higher? Ready for A tier? Ready for my A tier? Casually, I think this boss is fun to fight. Speedrun, it's lol, but I think casually, this one's fun to do. Plus, the lore on this one's super cool. Plus, the soundtrack is cool for this one. They're like Artorias, kind of. The God Eater, like the Eternal Suck. This fight is cool. People don't realize how hard this fight actually is in the speedrun. Good boss. I feel like a badass every time I perform the Dancer fight optimally. You know, Dancer's got like a cult following on her ass. So, two swords, spin to lose. Dancer's cool, okay? You can fight Dancer early to like feel like a badass casually. I thought about putting this one in S tier because I love this fight. Like its presentation, the two phases, how badass you feel when you do the strats, how dangerous they are. Same with Dragon Slayer armor. Interesting lore. Very fun boss fight. Like when you learn how to fight, like with the strafes and everything. The longer this fight lasts, the lamer it kind of gets. So I like really like the speed strats. Like I could do without the Pilgrim Butterflies throwing shit at you. All right. So here are my S tier picks because I love all of these fights. These are my favorite fights. All of these fights really well done. They're all hard. They're all dangerous. They all have good lore behind them. This one's probably the most controversial because people hate Phase 2 Frieda, but I actually don't mind Phase 2 Frieda. Phase 3, you got, like, if you played this casually and, like, you were, like, super excited, you finally battled your way through Phase 2, that annoying mess of a fight, you're like, and then she comes up again. She rises again with the black flame to smush you into smithereens. It's really nice. Soul Ascender, fantastic final boss for the base game. It sums up Dark Souls perfectly. The lore is interesting. The fight's insane. It's complex. Like, there's so much to it. Like, you can fight Cinder, like, a bunch of different times. There's just so much that goes into the, like, moveset that he has, what he can do, the memes, the soundtrack, you know, the nostalgia you get when he does phase two, and he has, like, the Gale moveset. It's like chef's kiss. It's beautiful. Do we have to say much about this one right here? This fight is fucking incredible. Music volume set to 10. Slave Knight Gale, his little bitch ass, simping so hard for Lady Frida, which I don't blame him. Slave Knight Gale goes fucking nuts. His moveset changing twice, like he has the monkey phase where he like fucking goes literally ape on you. Then he like stands upright and starts fighting you. And then he fucking does the second phase change, and then he goes fucking crazy again. Very epic, epic conclusion to the Ring City. Nameless King. He's got a big cock. And by that I mean he's got the chicken dragon. This boss gave me hell when I first played it casually. The weapon he has is fucking cool. His helmet? Cool. His soundtrack? Cool. The presentation of his arena? Cool. What a cool boss, okay? Like, he's using the weapon that was used to fight the dragons to fight alongside the dragons. How epic is that, dude? Nameless King, very cool. This is my Dark Souls 3 tier list, guys. It may be controversial. I'm sorry that I put Pontiff in B tier. His toes just weren't strong enough. Look at this, like, delicious curve, this bell curve of a tier list. I mean, the shit tier, I don't actually think, like, there's that many shit tier bosses in this game. But, yeah, this curve, it's pretty beautiful. I like majority of the bosses in this game. I think that's why I like this game so much. So, yeah. Thanks for enjoying the controversial take on Dark Souls 3, guys.